To see polar bears up close and personal in the wild, we flew to Churchill on the Hudson Bay. The whole area is flat tundra, dotted with fresh water ponds. Churchill is a town of about 900 people, surrounded by over 1,000 polar bears. This traffic represents rush hour on the main street. Churchill touts being the polar bear capital of the world, along with other terrestrial and aquatic animals and birds. This polar bear won't surprise anybody, but sometimes the real deal pays a surprise visit and is usually captured and thrown in the clink. This is the polar bear holding facility just outside of town. If they are repeat offenders, they're held for 30 days and then they're released about 30 miles away from town. Signs warn the visitors not to wander too far out. Churchill has its Arctic version of a beach on the icy Hudson Bay. This stone landmark is an Inukshuk, built by the Inuit as a marker for navigation or campsites, places of veneration, or to mark a cache of food. This is not the Pacific Ocean. It's the Hudson Bay. Ooh, it's cold. So let's go scout some polar bears. The Churchill Wildlife Management Area is about a 20-minute bus ride from Churchill, and that is the approved range for the Tundra Buggies. It all starts at the Tundra Buggy Launch Area.
How you doing, Luke?
Good, yourself?
Good.
Beautiful morning?
Yep.
These massive vehicles hold up to 40 eager people.
For those wondering, this is pretty much top speed.
This big buggy looks like it would crunch any monster truck at a demolition derby. The huge tires are 5.5 feet high and about 3.5 feet wide. Polar bears conserve their strength by frequent resting. This often makes them difficult to spot. So let's say you're walking along a trail. Can you spot the bear? How about this one? It's a little more difficult. Try this one. This one is within spitting distance of the trail.
Hi, I'm Joanne Simerson, and I'm representing Polar Bears International here on this fabulous day in Churchill, Canada. And we are on an amazing tundra buggy out here looking at the polar bears. You can see over here on my shoulder, we have two male polar bears, both sleeping. They're conserving as much energy as they can. It's late October right now, and they're just waiting for the ice to form. About July sometime this year, the ice melted and all the bears came off the ice, which is their primary habitat and where they make their living. when they come off the ice. The moms that are pregnant go into the denning area 40 miles from here inland to dig their dens and have their cubs. Females that have young cubs came in a little bit further, and then young bears came in a little bit, and the big males stayed right on the coast resting. It's late October, they're waiting for the ice to form. The greatest threat to polar bears right now is climate change and loss of their sea ice habitat. A question we get a lot about polar bears is where do they get their water from? At this time of the year, they're lucky because we have lots of fresh water here on the land. As it starts to freeze up, they'll dig through that little bit of ice, punch through it, and they're actually able to drink the water. But once everything freezes up, if a polar bear has to get fresh water, they actually lower their body temperature because they're having to eat ice and snow. For polar bears, since the majority of their food is actually the blubber on a seal, the metabolic process of digesting fat produces water. And for polar bears out on the sea ice, that's the way they get their fresh water. That's one of the reasons that polar bears won't survive on terrestrial foods, even deer or caribou, if they were so lucky to catch one, is because the fresh water, or the water needed to metabolize protein, would dehydrate them. So polar bears are all about the blubber of the seal, and they're all ice-dependent seals. Without our Arctic sea ice, we have no bears.
Well, we saw plenty of polar bears and had a fun time on the Tundra Buggy, along with a lot of fun people. It was definitely a win-win adventure.